What is up, YouTube? It's Kingfisher745, and welcome to an all-new episode of All Hail the King. This will be episode 24, and it features a Cannonball PvP team-up. But before we get into the action, I do want to invite you to take a look at thehelicarrier.com. On this website, you're going to find a ton of information about Marvel Avengers Alliance. You can also check out current and past episodes of the From the Helicarrier podcast. That's where you can find each one of my segments even before I post the video. So just check out the corresponding link in the description below, and then you can explore the site. Now this week's episode is going to focus on Angel and Cannonball, and their first opponents are going to be a Falcon and Pestilence Beast team. Now how this team up is going to work is on Angel's turn, I will use Rapture, and that's a quick action ability. This is going to give allies an extra turn next round. By itself, this could allow Cannonball to use his kinetic field, and then nothing's impossible on the same round. But nothing's impossible also has Finest Hour, so we're going to need some of those buffs. Well, luckily, Angel has that on his level 1. Absolution gives Rising Up, so a chance to gain Focused, Fortified, Agile, or Strengthened. And these buffs will be applied to your entire team. Plus, we get to damage the enemy agent, so that's pretty hard to beat. Now hopefully they don't erase those buffs, and they don't, they use the grief instead. So now on Cannonball's turn we can use his level 9, and that is a quick action. I use this to mainly apply melt armor, and also the hopefully proc collateral damage. So let's go ahead and see what we can do with cleared for takeoff. And it does proc collateral damage. Next I'm going to use our level 6, and that is a ground attack that applies winded, off balance, and exhausted. The exhausted part is very beneficial, and it will also help out Cannonball against tacticians. Next up is the enemy Falcon, and we do get a generalized on him from Angel's passive. Then on my agent's turn, I'm going to show you what really can help make this team up amazing. First, we'll use the neurotrope, and this isn't exactly necessary, but it can help with Finest Hour, of course. Next up, if you were lucky enough to get this item, then you can really utilize it with this team. Oh, but first, look at all those Finest Hour buffs. We have Strengthened, Fortified, Focused, and Agile. The only bad part is we do have Exhaustion, so that will cut this down a little bit. But, the Mark of the Brotherhood gives Rally and Morale Boost. What Rally is going to do is allow Kinetic Field to be a quick action, and that first ability of Angel's, Absolution, will also become a quick action. Oh, and meanwhile, we did hit their agent for 203,000 damage. I have to say, that's pretty sick. So now we're going to use Kinetic Field, and this buff allows you to unlock Nothing's Impossible. So on our next turn, because of Angel, remember we got that extra turn, we're going to get to use Nothing's Impossible even though we were exhausted. This attack has Brutal Strike, Deadly Crits, and Finest Hour. So let's go ahead after Falcon. And we end up missing him, unfortunately. With my agent, I'll gain an extra turn because of Momentary Advantage, and then I'm going to swing away with the Hand of Apocalypse. Let's go ahead and try the one-shot beast with our first attack. So here goes nothing. And he does dodge it. But if at first you don't succeed, try again. Here goes our second hit with the hand. I have to admit I'd be pretty mad if this missed once again. But it doesn't. It gets 134k non-crit. And last, let's go for Falcon. We take him down to 2300 HP. So here you can see Absolution is a quick action, so we can use it twice. Only once will be needed, and it does 89,000 itself. So moving on to our second battle, hopefully Cannonball's Nothing's Impossible lands this time. Once again, we don't have the best team order. It would be best for our agent to go first, and then Angel. But we'll still make do, and at least Angel gets to go before Cannonball. Right after this enemy team almost KOs our agent because of mental coordination, I'm going to use Rapture with Angel. Then after this ability, I do have a pretty tough decision. Should I use Absolution for Rising Up, or should I go with our level 9 heal? I'm going to go ahead and heal and place that Resurrect on my agent. Then on the enemy agent's turn, he's going to use Voodoo Staff. So now Cannonball once again is going to use Cleared for Takeoff, hopefully to get that proc from the Explosive Empowered ISO 8. Unfortunately, this time he doesn't get it, and we also miss with the attack. Next, I'm going to use Crash Landing, and that's definitely because we need to exhaust all the enemies, especially that Tactician Agent. Not to mention, Winded and Off Balance really hurt this Quick Lock team. Then it's time for the Neurotrope as a quick action, the Mark of the Brotherhood, which is also a quick action, once again because of the quick and powered Ice Await, and then I still get to attack with the Hand of Apocalypse. So you know what, let's go ahead and hit Quicksilver, and maybe we can one-shot him. It looks like we're going to do it with a 78k crit. Now the enemy agent spams Voodoo Staff once again, and we'll definitely take that. Plus we even get an Absolution counterattack. So now we can use Kinetic Field as a quick action, then finally follow it up with a Nothing's Impossible. This one is going to do a respectable amount of damage, and it's a guaranteed crit. So there you have it, we get 128,000 damage. Now that is how this team's supposed to work. Let's go ahead and win this match with the Hand of Apocalypse, and then I'll move on to our final fight. It's the exact same team that we started this episode with, but only this team is a little bit tougher. This agent has the Tactician and Powered Costume, and he has some of the Demon set. I've also changed one thing on my team, and that's to use the Scroll of Agnizak instead of the Neurotrope. The reason for this is because Angel using 2x Absolution can easily give you those Rising Up buffs, but you're going to need to keep them, and the Scroll will do that. So let's use our first seal, followed by the Mark of Brotherhood. Now we get to keep all of our buffs and we don't have to worry about the cube. Truthfully, it can get really frustrating with the enemies removing Finest Hour buffs over and over again. Now the enemy Pestilence is going to use his Mask of the Red Death, and that will be the end of his turn. That is definitely a benefit of Cannonball going first. So now with Angel, we get to use Rapture, and then we get to use Absolution times 2. It's a melee slashing buff, so that's why Rally works on it. With all of our attacks, we go after Falcon, but we barely budge his HP because of all the dodging. So now he's going to use his swoop attack on Angel. We did get to generalize him, but he does pass his contagion. So now on Cannonball, who has a decent amount of rising up buffs, we're going to use Kinetic Field as a quick action, and then Nothing's Impossible. So let's hit that enemy Falcon and see if we can finish him. That's usually no easy feat, but we do manage to hit him for 67k, and that's going to KO him. Then the enemy agent does fire a hot shot, but he points it in the air, so no wonder he misses Angel and Cannonball. My agent did get stunned, but we still have an extra turn because of Angel. With that, I'll use Momentary Advantage, and so it looks like we'll get an extra turn after all. Next, I'm going to use the Mark of the Brotherhood, and we'll reapply Rally and Morale Boost. Then I'm going to use the second Seal of Agnizak, and what this does is gives all attacks Ethereal Strike and Ignore Defense. But it does also reduce the damage done by the enemies on their next attack. Then after all that, I suppose we might as well use the Hand of Apocalypse on Beast. I don't think we'll get one-shot damage, but we will take a 53k hit. Next, the enemy Pestilence Beast is going to use the Heart of Darkness on Cannonball. And he also gets a second turn, so he uses it again. Now, since he already got Tactical Maneuvers, we might as well hit him with a Cleared for Takeoff. Once again, I use this for Melt Armor, and also for a hopeful collateral damage, which we do score once again. Okay, and here comes another Heart of Darkness, and Cannonball's almost taken out. So apparently I was wrong, but at least we get to use Crash Landing, and hopefully exhaust the enemies now. Boy, I tell you, tacticians can be really tough. Truthfully, I think this is unfortunate for blasters like Cannonball. There's just tacticians everywhere, and they hardly have any checks. But since they did use the Light Fantastic, I'm going to use the third seal, and this will place Despair on them. I hate when the enemy heals, so I really love this debuff. Then I'm going to use Improbability Field, and that should be the end of our turn. I'm pretty sure that Beast won't die, so he's probably going to attack Cannonball, but he ends up missing, so now we get a chance to heal him with Angel. We can now use our level 9 as a quick action, and we'll place that on Cannonball. Believe it or not, this is going to heal him all the way back to full health. Next, I'm going to use Rapture on the enemy Pestilence. This is going to deal just enough damage, and then still leaves us with one more attack on their agent. So lastly, we're going to get to finish the fight with an attack from Cannonball. Well, sort of. Our coming through leaves him with just 1000 HP, and he dies to dots. So that's going to be it for this episode of All Hail the King. I really hope you enjoyed our Cannonball team up. I'd like to thank you all for watching and encourage you to go ahead and watch some other episodes of All Hail the King. You can click on any of the videos on your screen and it'll take you to a different episode. Lastly, I'd like to thank you all for watching and ask you to please like, comment, and subscribe. And until next time, good luck and take care.